Welcome back to a brand new Coffee Tech Update with Jan. Hopefully you enjoyed my last video where I walk you through the room wiring. So I showed you a lot of different rooms and what is needed for every room, looking at power, networking, the architecture, etc. It's where I get a lot of questions about all the time. So I also created a playlist. So in case you need to go to different chapters and look at different room scenarios, just look at those playlists so you can easily switch between those different scenarios. So hopefully that was helpful. Now, today I have a great update again, and that is about the Studio USB. So we have introduced a new version for this one, and that is version 1.4. Studio USB, and I think everybody knows this device by now. It's a very popular all-in-one speaker and just one USB cable to the laptop. Use it with Teams, Zoom, WebEx, Starleaf, whatever video client you have in your laptop. You put it at the front of the table, and you can use it very easily. It's got all kinds of features inside: speaker track, group track, presenter track. It's got all kinds of noise block features. I think it's really one of the maybe the most powerful all-in-one speaker that I've seen in the market today. And as I said, it is a very, very popular speaker bar at the moment. So there's a brand new update. So I wanted to walk you through in a small presentation what those new features are for the Studio USB, and I will show you how easy it is to install those different versions, because you can do an offline install, so without internet you can do an online installation using the software on the laptop. You can do it through Lens, so I will quickly walk you through those different options. Now let me show you on my laptop where you can find the software and all those new information. And of course, don't forget to take a coffee in between. Now, this brand new version, where can you find it? So you go to support.polycom.com, and there you go to Peripherals, and under Peripherals you will find all the USB devices that we have within Poly. So also you can find the Poly Studio. Now, what you find on the Poly Studio is there is here also the option for the companion app, and this is the app on your laptop where you can do an update using the companion app. But also there's an option for the provisioning, so you can download this package and update, for example, through your resource manager on-premise or your PDMSE, any of those platforms. But also there is a local update, which you can also do through the companion app, as you see here. So there's a lot of different options, and also there's Lens, which I will show you in a bit. Now, first of all, go to your companion app. So this is this local software package on your laptop, and check which version you have. So you go here on the top side with your right mouse click, and you go to Help About. And here you're able to find which version you are using. And I'm at the moment at version 1.5. Now, let me check what is the latest version on the Polycom support sites. So I go here and I click on the Poly Companion. And what will happen is will redirect me to specifically to this app. And as you will see, the latest version at the moment is 1.7. And not 1.5. So first, let me update the companion app. This is to make sure if there's any new features or settings, you got them available through this new app. So let me update this one. Agree. Right. Then you start the executable. Read through the license agreement. We click install. Make sure we will close my current companion app to make sure that all the files are updated. All right, and successfully completed. Let me now start the app. All right. Now, you can double check the version by again going to help about. And you see I got now version 1.7. Now, first off, to update, what you normally do is you have one tab that is the device settings where you can change specific settings. And the other tab, and what you also saw here is that red ball, is that there is an update. And here you will find if there's any updates available. And as you can see with Poly Studio, we have current version 1.3.2 and there's a new version 1.4. So what you can do is update from a local file. This is when I come in and maybe go to a customer. There's no direct internet connectivity. So I can then update it using a local file. I can also update it here using the app and locally through my laptop using USB, or we can use Lens, which I will show you a bit later. So what I will do is I will update now. You punch in the password. All right. And this means it will download now the new version and it will update it. Now, let me walk you quickly through this update that is available. Now, under the version 1.4, we see here also the release notes. So always recommend to walk through the release notes and to see what is new. So you always have an overview. Now, what is new in this version? First off, we have now full support for presenter mode. So this was a lab feature in the previous version, and presenter mode means when you're walking in the room that the camera on the fly will be able to follow you as a speaker. Really powerful. And you can look at one of my other videos where I did this for a Microsoft event. So that is now fully supported. But be aware, it's still under lab feature. It's not a lab feature anymore, but it's still there. So in the next version, we will take this out of the lab feature. But it is now a fully supported feature. So that's the first one. Now, another one that we have is there's a support for the framing size. So you can now set the exact zoom size when you put it into the presenter mode. So you can tweak that now under the camera settings. Now, also a possibility, which I think is very nice, is to support for audio source selection. Now, let me quickly explain to you the audio source selection, which is a new provisioning parameter for the Studio USB. Now, by default, the built-in mics are sufficient for most rooms. So you don't need any additional mics. Now, in case there are acoustic challenges with using built-in mics, you can also add an expansion mic optionally at the table, which gives you also directly at the speakers at the table and gives you that mic pickle. Now, by default, if you attach an additional expansion mic, all the microphone functionality will move to this device at the table. Now, in this new version, the 1.4, there's now a selection. And so by default, as I said, expansion mic is used, but you can also, using the provisioning environment, like Lens, you can also set it to auto. So that means that automatically it will select where the speaker is closest to. If it's closest to the mic at the table, it will use that mic. But if a speaker is walking in the room and comes closer to the Studio USB mics, it will use those built-in mics. So this is a brand new option, and I thought it might be useful for some scenarios. Now, also at the table, you have this button where you can easily mute the audio if you want. You just wave over it and it will mute and unmute. So also additionally, you have this at the table. Now, there comes a cable along, which is, I think, almost 8 meters. So you can always have this at the table if you got a mic pickup or you got acoustic challenges in the room, and they can easily add this. But you can also now combine both mics, which I think is very powerful. Now, that is concerning support for audio source selection. So you got this additional parameter now to change that behavior to auto, for example, to use both mics. Now, in this new version, we also have now official support for Poly Lens, and I will show you that in a bit. And further, we got some provisioning enhancements. So you can use this all through Lens, Wi-Fi parameters, etc. So there's a lot of new options has been added again, which you can all find in the release notes. Now, let's look at Lens. So in Lens, you can also do updates. So you will find more and more devices coming into Lens. So we already had the CCX, the VVX, we had the Trio 85, 8800, C60, Studio X, G7500, and we will get headsets in there. And in combination with Lens Desktop, which has also been launched, and you can use that all as a centralized hub with your desktop client in combination with this cloud platform to push policies, etc. I think you got a very, very powerful tool. Now, again, and you can also do updates from here. So you can go here to Studio USB, do software update, and again, select that version 1.4, and you can apply that version. I think very, very powerful. It's just a matter of applying here and select, and this will push out that version. So same thing, you can do it locally, you can do it through the companion app, and you can do this centrally through the Lens platform. Now, just a quick update on the Studio USB version 1.4. Hopefully it was useful. Again, I'm already looking forward to the next update. As I said, we got updates for Studio X. We got a Lens Desktop, which I can show you. So there's a lot of new features, versions, and products that are out there. So as soon as I got my hands on it, I will make sure you will get an update.